Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. I'm Nick Barber. We're outside of Tokyo this week at the Ceatec Expo with products and prototypes from Japan. We'll start with a prototype that is uniquely Japanese, a ping pong playing robot. It uses stereoscopic cameras to see the ball, and then an algorithm tells the robot where to position its paddle to return it. Supporting the machine are multiple computers that track the trajectory and velocity of the ball.
We are sensing and control plus sync to demonstrate the situation.
The machine is far from unbeatable. Despite its imposing 600 kilograms, it's more about getting a good rally going than trying to win. Omron is already using some of the sensing technology in its automated factory machines. Meet Aiko Chihara. She's not a human, but a humanoid robot. From Toshiba, the robot is controlled by 43 air servo actuators, which give it more lifelike motion.
And if the robot looks like a human being, some slight unnatural movement makes it very scary, you know, such kind of things.
The skin of the robot is silicone and looks very lifelike, but despite the humanoid's petite size, it has unnaturally large hands. One of the things the team wants to improve is the movement of those hands to make them more natural. It also wants to make the robot react to people and even potentially use it to engage the elderly in conversation. Smartwatches may be the most popular wearables right now, but that hasn't stopped Japanese startup 16 Lab from developing a sensor-equipped Smartring. The prototype, which doesn't have a name yet, will be available for pre-order later this year.
We are providing four major functions. Number one, gesture controller, and number two, alert function, and number three, contactless key and e-wallet function.
Using an early prototype, one of the researchers was able to wave his hand and access functions on a tablet, like taking a picture or controlling music tracks. The ring will start shipping in the second quarter of 2015 in eight countries, including the US, Canada, parts of Europe, and Japan. When ordering, users will need to specify a ring size, because unlike smartwatches, the smart ring isn't adjustable. As I look at these bottles and try to figure out which one to buy, this small sensor from Fujitsu is tracking me. The system is able to tally the number of times you look at an item or overlay a heat map of the product you're most interested in.
So there's an infrared camera and an LED inside it. So the LED emits infrared light, which forms a reflection on your cornea. And the camera looks at that and then tracks the movement of your pupil with respect to that point. And from there, we do a bunch of calculations and figure out what you were actually looking at.
If you wear glasses that have any kind of anti-reflective coating, the system won't work. Second, each of these little devices needs to be plugged in via USB for both power and data. That makes deploying a number of them to supermarkets or large stores unfeasible for the time being. The next time you're backing up, changing lanes, or parking, you might like this new camera system from Sharp. Called 360-degree FreeView, the system includes four 1-megapixel cameras mounted on the car. The images from the wide-angle cameras are stitched together to create a real-time view around the vehicle. Sharp is planning to partner with automakers to bring the technology to cars by 2018. The camera modules will be available next year. The company also showed off this freeform display. It allows for a thin bezel and a display that isn't restricted to being rectangular. Based on the company's IGZO display technology, it could, for example, be built around a car speedometer and other gauges. It will be commercialized by 2017. Every year at Ceatec, one of the big attractions are the balancing robots from Murata. This year, the company's balancing robots worked as a team. These cheerleading robots use a variety of sensors to stay balanced atop a ball.
ロボットそのものが倒立をするっていう倒立の技術です。で、それから2つ目が、ロボットの位置を計測してリアルタイムにフィードバックする位置計測の技術。で、から3つ目がそれらのロボットが台数が複数台おりまして、そのロボットたちを全体としてのコントロールをする技術、群制御の技術になります。
In the demonstration, 10 robots performed a synchronized routine which was controlled over a wireless network. Four of the bots fell over, though, and needed to be moved to the sidelines. It took about 20 researchers and engineers a year and a half to design and perfect the robots. Murata adds its cheerleaders to two other balancing robots, bicycling Murata Boy and unicycling Seiko-chan, both shown off in past years at the exhibition. Well, that's our show for this week. Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. To find out what's coming up on every week's show, be sure to follow us on Facebook and Twitter. As we head out, we'll leave you with shots of a dancing robotic dinosaur. I'm Nick Barber, and for all of us here at the IDG News Service, thanks for watching, and we hope to see you next week when I'm back in Boston.